Hello boys, welcome back to another session of video tutorials, and this session is meant for class 11th biology students, and this is for 21st November 2020. And as all of you know, we are into the revision mode and we are revising a very important chapter called Cell Cycle and Cell Division, chapter number 10. In our last session, we were talking about the cell division and we also talked about the cell cycle, and we said the cell cycle will have important phases such as M phase, interphase and S phase. So in M phase, basically it is divided, we can say the cell cycle can be divided into two main phases. One is interphase and the second one is M phase. In interphase, it is the phase between two successive M phases, as all of you know, that is mitotic phase. The interphase is called the resting phase, but I said we can no more call it as resting phase, as the cell prepares itself for the division. It is preparatory phase. It is very correct to call this as preparatory phase. The interphase lasts more than 95% of the duration of the cell cycle. Again, this is NEET exam question. Longest duration phase is interphase, 95%. In this phase, the cell prepares for division by undergoing both cell growth and DNA replication in an orderly manner. And this contains three subphases. We talked about it: G1 phase, S phase and G2 phase. And then the subphase of G1 gap 1 phase, S for synthetic phase, and G2 gap 2 phase, all these three will be followed by mitosis phase, M phase. And you know that M phase has got four subdivisions, that is prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. M phase represents the phase when actual cell division or mitosis occurs. In the 24-hour average duration of cell cycle of a human cell, cell division proper lasts for only about an hour. The M phase starts with the nuclear division, that is karyokinesis we said, and corresponding to the separation of daughter chromosomes. And then karyokinesis will be followed by division of the cytoplasm, we call it cytokinesis. So in animals, mitotic cell division is only seen in diploid somatic cells, except the gametes we said yesterday. Plants show mitotic division in both haploid as well as diploid cells. So M phase is the most dramatic period of the cell cycle, involving a major reorganization of virtually all components of the cell. The number of chromosomes in parent as well as in progeny cell remains the same. So it is called as equitational division. Cell division is a progressive process, and very clear-cut lines cannot be drawn between various stages, because sometimes phases can overlap each other. Although for convenience, mitosis is divided into four substages, that is prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. So first subphase is prophase. Prophase is the first phase of mitosis, followed by G2 phase, and it involves the following events: initiation of condensation of chromosomal materials. So condensation starts. Movement of centrioles towards opposite poles of the cells. At the end of the prophase, endoplasmic reticulum, nuclear membrane, Golgi complex disappears. So prophase is the first stage of mitosis, which follows the S phase and G2 phases of interphase. The new DNA molecules formed during this S phase are not distinct but intertwined. Prophase is marked by the initiation of condensation of chromosomal material. The chromosomal material becomes untangled during the process of chromatin condensation. The centrosome, which is duplicated during the S phase of the interphase, now begins to move towards the opposite poles of the cells. Like if you take the cell in this fashion, now you got centrioles moving to the opposite poles, and the chromosomes which are lengthy, first it will be in the form of chromosomal chromatin reticulum, and this becomes the chromatin reticulum becomes thick and condensed like this. So you can see the formation of chromosomes. The completion of prophase is marked by following character of events. Number one, chromosomal material condenses to form compact mitotic chromosomes. Chromosomes are seen to be composed of two chromatids attached together at the centromere. So as the prophase progresses, we can see this chromosome in this fashion. So you have got chromatid 1 and chromatid 2, both are interlinked with the centromere. So we can see two threads having a bead like structure centromere. Centrosome begins to move towards opposite poles. We can see the centrosome moving to opposite poles like this, north pole and south pole. Each centrosome radiates out microtubules called esters. Now what happens is, once the centromeres reach the poles, opposite poles, the astral rays will be formed this way. So the cytoplasm will be made to form like a threads like this. So these are called asters, and so as this, the spindle like structures. So basically this is centromere, and there will be rays around it like this. This is asters. The two asters together with the spindle fibers form mitotic apparatus. So you get the mitotic apparatus. Cell at the end of prophase, when viewed under the microscope, do not show Golgi complex. When we see this, no Golgi complex, no ER, endoplasmic reticulum, no nucleolus, because nucleolus itself will form centromeres, and nuclear membrane disappears. So these are the events that can be observed. And further, phase 2 we go. Metaphase. So you can see here early prophase condensation, and here later prophase you can see the chromosomes and chromatids with centromeres. In metaphase, the complete disintegration of the nuclear envelope marks the start of metaphase. The chromosomes are spread throughout the cytoplasm of the cell. By this stage, condensation of chromosomes is completed and they can be seen clearly under the microscope. This is the stage at which morphology of chromosomes is most easily studied. Metaphase chromosome is made up of two sister chromatids, which are held together by centromere. Small disc-shaped structures at the surface of the centromeres are called kinetochores. These structures serve as the sites of attachment to spindle fibers. Let's see here, look at this. So you can see the formation of spindle fibers, and the chromosomes are lying in the center of the plate, and nuclear membrane completely disappeared, and the chromosomes are having attachment through kinetochores. Metaphase is characterized by all the chromosomes coming to lie at the equator. As you are seeing, this is the equator. All chromosomes are lying at the equator, with one chromatid of each chromosome connected by its kinetochore, you can see here, kinetochore to spindle fibers from one pole, and its sister chromatid connected by its kinetochore to spindle fibers from the opposite pole. So one is the north pole, another is the south pole. The plane of alignment of the chromosomes at metaphase is referred to as metaphase plate. So the key features of metaphase, what do you observe in metaphase? How do you know, once we place any cell that is undergoing mitotic division, how do you know that the cell is under metaphase? First and foremost, spindle fibers attach to kinetochores of the chromosomes. Second, all chromosomes are moved to spindle equator and get aligned along metaphase plate through spindle fibers to both the poles. The moment you look through the microscope, and you observe that all the chromosomes are lying in the center of the plate like NCC single file, take it for granted that it is metaphase. So that is the characteristics of anaphase. Related to this, you will be performing, once you come back to the lab and you start doing biology practicals, you will be doing the onion root, and you will observe all the four phases of mitosis in that. And how to identify each phase, you have to know the important characteristics of that phase. How do you know that the root cell or any cell is under metaphase? All the chromosomes, condensed chromosomes, are lying in the center of the plate. That is metaphase. So we go ahead next about anaphase. Until then, draw diagrams, label it, understand the significance of each